Bruce, welcome to my YouTube channel. How are you?
I'm great, thank you. I'm great, Ataro.
Well, thank you very much for your time. Thank you very much for this opportunity. I appreciate a lot. I appreciate a lot.
It's my pleasure.
When we read about your biography, you did a lot of things.
I've been around a long time.
Yeah, a long time. Do you feel that the time it goes fast?
It's but when you think back, you think, well, it is a long time, but between the last years, it's got faster and faster. It's just crazy. But it's I don't know. It's it, my son said to me, he said, when was the best era for you? And I said, the best era? I said, now.
Okay.
Now is the best era. He said to me, so I've got a lot to look forward to then. So I said, yeah. I think so,
Oh, so nice, so nice.
Yeah.
Do you feel that you had a happy career? Do you enjoy it?
I mean, it's an amazing gift to have this all of my life, to have music all my life, from when I was young. I was professional musician when I was 16. I've been in band since I was 13, and these to wake up every day and play every day, especially when I started to write music, I started to write songs. Basically, it's getting up every day, and I'm still writing. I was writing this morning, and I'm going to be writing when I leave you.
Oh, nice.
I'm going back in the studio. So I it's it, you know they say to achieve well-being, to achieve happiness, is to achieve something every day, so even something small, but every day. When you're making music, you do that every day, and it's a great gift.
Of course, of course. Well, and I want to know your inspiration, when you wrote those lyrics and when you're still writing, of course. I want to know what was in your mind, doing those lyrics.
Well, I look back at my lyrics, and they're often, I think you can only write from your own experience, or from your own experience when you've experienced it. You might even have experienced it in a book, but I think everything becomes part of us. Everything we eat becomes part of us. Everything we hear becomes part of us. And people, you fall in love with a man or a woman or whatever, and they become part of you. And you lose somebody as a friend or whatever, you lose them, and you suffer because they're part of you. They're part of you. Your music is part of you. Your songs are part of you. Your playing is part of you. So that all makes up the inside of a human experience,
Nice, so nice. Well, for example, you've been there in the Argent band, you write music for the guitarist of Deep Purple, you do a lot of music. How you say you are still doing music. I don't know if you're going to have a new stuff for this year or maybe next year.
A new what?
A new
A new
stuff, new songs.
a new yeah 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 I mean I have two albums waiting to come out.
Wow.
They're waiting to come out. I'm just looking for a record company to release them. I've made one album of the hits that I've written for others, for other people, the hits I've written for Santana, for people like Roger Daltrey, for Richie Blackmore's Rainbow, and America, those bands. I've made my own versions because I originally made the demos for them as well. So I've made new recordings, and then I've got songs, new songs that I've written in the last 2 years,
Wow.
to release.
Well, so nice. Well, for example, one of those songs that you wrote from Hot Chocolate, it's so nice, so nice. So You Win Again.
So you're
It was a big
you
hit.
win again. You win again. Here I stand again. It was a big, big hit everywhere, all over the world. That was a big hit. Number one in England, number one in the UK, number one in Germany, big hit in America. It wasn't such a big hit in America because the production was very English. It was a soul song, but it was a very English production. But it's yeah, it was good.
Well, you say that. I want your opinion about this thing. Why is it so difficult to have a hit in United States? And the difference, Europe, UK, and United States with those things,
Well, it can be several different occurrences. Basically, you sort of it might be the record company is a different record company and the other side of the world, or 5,000 miles away. It could be that maybe the production isn't the right kind of sound, but usually I do believe that the song is really about communication. If it communicates with that territory, sometimes it communicates because it sounds American, or whatever. It communicates when it sounds it's British, So there's a lot of different reasons.
But You Can Do Magic was one of the gorgeous songs that I heard, it was so nice, that lyric. At first one is very catchy, but have a great message, a love message. So I want to know the story of this great hit.
I never believed in things that I couldn't see. I never believed in things that I couldn't see. Now I'm more open to that. But and I wrote that in the song. I never believed in things that I couldn't see. I said, if I can't feel it, then how can it be? No magic happened to me. And then I saw you. Then I believe in magic. It's that idea, So it's a very simple idea. It's a love song. And you know darn well when you cast your spell, you will get your way when you hypnotize. It was a very hypnotic song. The sound was hypnotic, So it was very enjoyable to do because I produced it as well for Dewey Dewey and Jerry from America. I recorded at Abbey Road and they flew over. I did the backing myself. I recorded the drums. I recorded the bass, keyboards and guitar, and I did it. I did all the recording, and the boys came in, the two guys came in and sang it,
White America, not like a song from a Russ Ballard album,
They already had a big following. I haven't toured America since 1976. It's a long, long time, If I was on the road all the time, I think that would have happened, but I've never been on the road all the time, I've been on the road with Roger Daltrey. I did a tour. That's the last time I toured in the States. That was with Roger Daltrey. I was doing my own songs with him as well. I was playing the guitar and basically singing a couple of songs myself in his set. But that was nice. That was 1985. That's the last time I went to America.
Well, if we have to talk about magic lyrics, Voices, your other hit, I think that the lyric is, I feel it's so very dark, in a way, the
That's what
lyrics.
Brian Adams said that to me. Brian Adams, Brian Adams, don't you?
Yes, of course.
He phoned me 10 o'clock at night. I was getting into bed. I never met him. This was at the time when Voices had been out. It'd been played a lot in America. He phoned, and he spoke to the lady that works for me, and she said, there's a guy called Brian Adams. She had never heard of him. She said, his name is Brian Adams. Shall I tell him you're phoning back tomorrow? I said, no, I'll have a word with him. So I went downstairs and he said, I'm a big fan of yours. He said, I'd like to meet you. So I went to Abbey Road the next day. We met at Abbey Road. He had never been there before. And I wanted to show him around, And he said that he'd done this album with Tina Turner, or he'd done a duet with Tina Turner, It's Only Love. And he said, what I want to do is I want to produce a song for Tina's album. He said, would you write one? He said, I love Voices. He said it's so introspective. I said, yeah. We don't use that word very much in England, introspective. It's used a lot in America. And he said, I'd like to produce. I said, do you want to write it together? Is that what you want to do? He said, no, you write the song and I'd like to produce it. So I did write a song and sent it to him, but it got lost somewhere. It got lost somewhere. I phoned him and it got lost somewhere. I don't know where. But it was got a note. It was called In the Crossfire, and that was an idea I had for Tina. And her manager asked me, Roger Davis asked me. I saw him at Abbey Road as well at the bar, you know. And he said to me, he said, Russ, could you write something? He said, I managed Tina. He said, would you write something for her? I said, yeah. And he said, she's upstairs in number three. Do you want to meet her? I said, yes. So I went upstairs and met her. And he said, Russ is going to write you a song. Well, I did write her a song, but sadly, it's too late now.
Wow. Wow. It's all about history, you know. This is all history.
It's history. Voices, I hear voices. I've got so many friends in the business, you know, that I've known, and people I've written songs for, you know, they're great friends of mine now, you know. I mean, I did a show, and Brian May did it with me, you know. I did a one man show. And I made contact with Brian at one time. I said, do you want to do it? Do you want to do it? He said, yeah, I'll come and do it with you. So he did the second half with me. And Rick Wakeman did it as well, which was nice. Rick Wakeman played keyboards. I play guitar. Brian May play guitar. So you meet these friends along the way, you know, you get to know them, you know, when we're a lot younger. And you stay friends. Roger Daltrey, you know, you just, people come into your life and they go, you know, and it's great. I'm meeting people all the time. I've got this band I'm working with now called Space Elevator, and they are many, many, many years younger than me, but they're a great band. Great, got a great, great singer who's magic, you know, a girl called, they call her the Duchess. She is a great, great singer, and a great guitar player who I've been working with. And, you know, that. Over the last few months, we've become really, really close friends, you know, and that's what I love, because they're friends for life, you know. Especially, it's all about music, you know, and it's great.
So nice, so nice. I want to know your opinion about business records, you know, because when I do interviews with other artists from the 70s, 80s, you know, maybe they don't have great experiences, you know, with the record companies. I want to know about your opinion of those things.
Opinions of record companies.
Your personal opinion, you know.
If you get a major, you know, if you get CBS or Universal or Warner Brothers, RCA or Capitol, one of the biggest, you know, they can make hits. They can't make hits, you know, if they get their, you know, if they get the machine going, they can make hits. I've seen that happen. So people that don't have the big major record companies behind them suffer, because it's so difficult. You know, a major record company can spend $50,000 on a video, $100,000 on a video, which makes all the difference in becoming a hit. You know, you can't spend that kind of money when you are not with a major record company.
Of course.
So that's very frustrating. You know, with Space Elevator, I would like to get something for them. So, we've got some great tunes. And I'd like to get, because Julie, the Duchess, is a great performer. She's a great performer of a lyric, of the story of the song. She can perform it so you believe it, you know? And it is frustrating for anyone that's, you know, a good musician that's trying to get music out.
And it was frustrating for you in your beginnings.
Yeah, well, I turned professional. And we had a record company. We had EMI straight away. The Beatles were on EMI. The Shadows, Cliff Richard, people over here were on EMI. We were on EMI. But, but then we were a backing band, with Adam Faith. We had a few hits here. We had a big hit in America. But, I've had different careers at RO, very different careers from that. From the 60s now, right to now, different bands with different record companies, and but it's all great, it's all great, it's all fabulous. While you're making music, it's just uplifting.
So nice. Yeah. And
And
if you could go back in time, would you change something of your personal career, your professional career?
I look back, no, not really. No,
Okay, nice.
not really.
Fantastic that. I want to go back in times, and I want to know about the story of the beginning of that smash hit you have in the 80s, because it was very popular here in Latin America, in South America, Voices, especially thanks to Miami Vice, Division Miami. And I want to know the story of that song.
Well, that's a song. You see, you heard me on that because I had a good record company. I had EMI America then, didn't I? It was EMI America. So that, and it got a lot of publicity because, but it was too dark, It was too introspective to become a real, real big hit, but everyone knows it. Go to Germany, when we start that wee, wee, wee at the beginning, and the crowd will cheer, so it's great. I get them to sing it as well, don't look back, look straight ahead, don't turn away from what it said, don't look back, yes, it is gone, and the crowd sing it with me, so that is cool. I got the key.
I got the key. I got
I
the
got the
key.
key.
Oh my God.
Well, the idea of the lyric, you see, the idea of the lyric was, I've never written a lyric like that before, but I'm pretty introspective myself, you see. So I'm looking, I'm trying, that just happened. That lyric happened, and I'm saying in my head, the voice is waiting, like this, my brain is waiting. It's waiting for me to set it free. It's like, if you could see my mind, if you really look deep, maybe you'll find somewhere there would be a place hidden behind my chameleon face. You will find somewhere there's a house. And this is all in my head. Somewhere there's a house. And inside that house, there's a room. Locked in that room, in the corner you see, there's a voice waiting for me to set it free. And I got the key. I the key. And that's it, And in my head, the voice is waiting for me to set it free. I locked it inside my imagination, inside that room. But I'm the one that's got the combination. Some people didn't like what the voice did say, so I took the voice and I locked it away. But I got the key. I got the key. Voices, I hear voices. Don't look back. Look straight ahead. Don't turn away. Then the voice, it said, look, don't look back. Yesterday's gone. Don't turn away. You can take it on. Anything you can take it on. But do it with love. Do it with love, and do it with, do it with heart. And every day is great. Every moment is great. Nothing to worry about. You can see my mind. If you really look deep, then maybe you'll find. I'm somewhere there'll be a place hidden behind my chameleon face. You'll find somewhere there's a house, and inside that house there's a room.
Who will you thank, one person, in your life?
It's been an inspiration. An inspiration.
Yeah, why not?
Can I give you two?
Okay, give me two.
Mum and dad.
Ah, nice.
My mum was a dancer, and my dad was a drummer, and he played the piano as well. They were very inspiring. It was them that sent me to piano lessons, then guitar. My mum wanted me to, she was a dancer, she wanted me to go to dance lessons, you know. And I said, I'll go anywhere, you know. And she said, well, there won't, she told me about 6 weeks later, there won't be, I said, how many boys are going to be there? And she said, probably not many. I said, I'm not going. I'm not going. I would like to have gone to dance lessons when I was a kid, but I wasn't going to go and be the only boy there, you know.
So if you have a few words, just I think that is a good opportunity.
And you can translate.
Yeah, I will put subtitles.
Yeah. I'd like to say hello to all my Argentine friends that are out there that have heard voices and maybe know some of the songs that I've written,
Of
produced,
course.
played on, or whatever. And I'd like to say hello, and I hope everybody's well. Stay well, keep the faith, keep listening, and I'll do my best. You've got the best footballers in the world. I've supported Tottenham Hotspur. We used to have Ozzy Ard Dealers, Ricky Villa.
Yeah.
My favorite Tottenham side ever, and obviously the others, you know, the others. You had a famous man from Napoli there. Thanks so much. People that have followed me love you. Love
Oh,
each
nice,
other.
nice. So,
Look after each other. Lots of love. Take care.
you we have a Maradona,
Yes. Yeah.
thank you very much, Ruth. Thank you very much for your time. Such an honor for me just being here talking to you again.
Thanks, Arturo. And I'll know your face now when I hear from you. It's good.
Yeah.
You've got a great face.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
You
Well,
could be in the
have a nice
band.
day. I wish you a nice week and a nice ending year because we have 3 months now for this year.
Yes, that's all. Yeah. Well, take care of yourself, and
Thanks.
we'll stay in touch anyway.
Muchas gracias.
I got the key. I got the key. I got the key.